shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who can be against us? He did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all. Will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died. Rather, was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish or distress? distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or the sword. Though in all these things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you, and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Would you please be seated for a few moments? My name is Father Dan Keneally. I'm the pastor here in San Francisco Diocese, and I'm part of that of our staff clergy. I wish to extend our condolences to the family and friends of Mary. I was grateful to hear some of the words that were prepared, I believe, by the family that Kevin read before Mass, just to hear a little bit about Mary. I saw the beautiful pictures out there, wonderful smile that she had. It is a great gift just to hear those few short, beautiful words that just spoke of friendship, family, love. faithfulness of Jesus, that what he promises in the waters of baptism, he doesn't forget about. It's not a distant memory, but that the flame of the Lord continues to burn, continues to shine, continues to remind us that each one of us is made for heaven. What a beautiful gift that the Father wants to remind us of that. That he doesn't lose anything that he created, but desires to bring it back to himself. You know, in the prayers before the Eucharist, I'll say these words: indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. An eternal dwelling is made ready for them. That's why we gather here to offer this Mass for Mary, to pray that she shares the life that God created her for, not merely here, but in heaven to come. I love the gospel that was chosen, the Beatitudes. Blessed are the poor in spirit, blessed are they who mourn, blessed are the meek. All these things that sometimes are looked down upon in our own day, but Jesus sharing them to show us that he exalts the lowliness of humanity. He exalts the things that the world tries to use for shame. He exalts those things and desires to raise us up back to himself. And so today we offer our prayer for Mary, that she would share the joy that God created her for, and that she would know the joy that she desired, that she lived in this life, that she would know that joy forever and ever. And so we offer our prayers, we offer this Mass, the highest way to give her praise, to give thanks for her life, and to express our hope for what we desire for her and for ourselves. May the soul of Mary and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. I invite you to please rise. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Call beseech your mercy, that she who did not doubt her son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection is dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. When this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Precious Lord.